Alright, in this video I'm going to do an example of finding the equation for a hyperbola. And again, kind of our two sort of standard forms. We can actually write this a little more generically, so I'll point that out here in this example. So we're going to find the equation for this hyperbola here, in the bottom left. We can write the equation of a hyperbola a little more generically by saying x minus h squared over a squared minus y minus k squared over b squared. H and k is going to be the point where your asymptotes are intersecting, okay? It's going to be the point equidistant from the vertices. So to me it looks like the vertices here are at 1, 2, 3. It looks like we have one of our vertices will be at 4, 0, and the other one will be at negative 4, 0. Okay, it looks like our asymptotes here are crossing then at the point 0, 0, so that means my hk is going to be equal to 0, 0, so I can fill that in at any point. Remember a, that's going to be the distance from where the asymptotes cross over to one of the vertices. So to me in this case it looks like our a value is going to be an a value of positive 4. Again, we're just simply moving 4 units to the right to get to that that vertice. So a is 4, and the last thing I'm going to use is, remember our asymptotes are at positive and negative. For this type, the ones that open to the left and to the right, we use positive and negative b over a x. But we know our a value in this case, we've already figured it out, that's 4. We just need to figure out our b value. Well, notice in this, our asymptote goes through the points 2, 1, and 4, 2. Okay, so you go up 1 over 2, up 1 over 2. So to me it looks like the slope of this line, at least this, this asymptote with a positive slope, to me it looks like this line has a slope of positive 1 over 2. Okay, so again, up 1 over 2, up 1 over 2. So our slope has is a positive 1 half. So our asymptote is going to be 1 over 2x. Well, I can rewrite this asymptote y equals 1 over 2x. I could get a denominator of 4. And if I multiply top and bottom by 2, I would get, well, 2 over 4x, as again, this asymptote. Since I know that my a value has my a value is positive 4, well then now this numerator must be our b value. So it says our b value is going to equal 2. And now we've got everything we need to fill in the equation for our hyperbola. So it says we'll have x minus 0 squared over a squared minus y minus 0 squared over b squared, which is 2 squared equals 1, and you could always multiply this out. It says our equation would be x squared over 16 minus y squared over 4 equals 1.